Sing, choirs of the world, may your voices take springs, there where fire burns. May your songs put roses, there where battlefields lay. Open furrow and sow love to harvest fruits of hope. Sing to liberty where despots rule. Sing to equality where poverty nests. Sing to love where hate prevails. May your singing direct the world, so that peace takes over wars, so that all will cherish the earth, so that all race or color discrimination is banished, so that we will be together as sisters and brothers, so that this planet rejoices with your voices.
In warm celebration of the Mapúa University's Christmas celebration, the Paskong Mapúan, the Mapúa University and the Mapúa Cardinal Singers present you, from the depths of our hearts, the first ever Mapuan Festival of Lessons and Carols. In this service, let us remember the beauty of Christmas through Christ's presence, and let us retell the story of His birth, along with the singing of carols, in hopes of gathering everyone's hearts and uplifting everyone's spirits in celebrating Christmas as a Mapuan community. May this event and our voices bring hope and peace to your minds.
Hi, good evening, dear Mapuans, families, and friends. I'm Mr. Jun Iron, your host for this year's first Mapuan Lessons and Carols, a festival of 9 lessons and carols for Christmas. Before we begin, let me share with you where did we adopted this tradition. The Festival of 9 Lessons and Carols is a format for a service of Christian worship celebrating the birth of Jesus that is traditionally followed at Christmas. The story of the fall of the humanity, the promise of the Messiah, and the birth of Jesus is told in 9 short Bible readings from Genesis, the prophetic books, and the Gospels, interspersed with the singing of Christmas carols. The format was based on an order drawn up by Edward White Benson, later Archbishop of Canterbury, but at that time Bishop of Truro in Cornwall, for use on Christmas Eve in 1880. Tradition says that he organized a 10 p.m. service on Christmas Eve in a temporary wooden shed serving as his cathedral, and that a key purpose of the service was to keep men out of pubs on Christmas Eve. The original liturgy has since been adopted and used by other churches all over the world. Lessons and carols must often occur in Anglican churches, but also in some Roman Catholic, Lutheran parishes, and Presbyterian institutions. However, numerous Christian churches have adopted this service, or a variation of this service, as part of this Christmas celebration. In the UK, the service has become the standard format for schools' Christmas carol services. This year, under Mapua's Office of the Student Affairs, the Mapúa Cardinal Singers is adopting this tradition to mark the beginning of Christmas in the university. This event aims to gather everyone's heart and to uplift everyone's spirit in celebrating Christmas as a community sings carols for Christmas. All the Christmas songs that will be featured today are specially arranged by Mr. Lester Delgado, composer. Join me as we celebrate the spirit of Christmas at Mapúa University through listening to the Gospels and singing of Christmas carols. Before we start, let us all listen to the Christmas message of our very own university president, Dr. Reynaldo B. Vea.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to commend the Mapúa Cardinal Singers for spearheading this community event called the first Mapuan Festival of Lessons and Chorals to open Mapua's celebration of Christmas, Paskong Mapuan. This event brings further joy and happiness to our community amidst the good development of the easing up of the pandemic in our country, it brings deeper meaning to and greater appreciation of our celebration of the singular gift that has been given humankind, the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ, by whose teaching we seek to live our daily lives. I would like to thank the MCS for being a major facet of life in Mapúa. You have been there to lend culture and refinement to many of our events. You have made Mapúa proud with the accolades that you have gained or won in international contests that you have joined. You have helped to make Mapúa whole. To the Mapúa Cardinal Singers and the Mapúa community, I wish you all a blessed and Merry Christmas and a normal and Happy New Year.
Thank you very much, Dr. Bea. The Festival of Lessons and Carols is a service of scripture and song that dates to the late 19th century. In this service, we listen to 9 scriptures lessons which recount the fall, the promise of the Messiah, the incarnation, and the great commission to preach the good news. Each lesson is followed by a carol that reflects on the lesson's message and a brief prayer. May I invite everyone to sing with us the opening hymn. The Invocation, to be followed by the singing of the Lord's Prayer.
Good evening to everyone, and I'm really pleased to pray now that the Lord may bless our meeting, carol and lessons, that He may bless each one of us, our families and countries. From the Psalm 85, let me hear what God the Lord will speak. He will speak peace to His people, to His faithful, to those who turn to Him in their hearts. Surely His salvation is at hand for those who fear Him, that His glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and faithfulness will meet. Righteousness and peace will kiss each other. Faithfulness will spring up from the ground, and righteousness will look down from the sky. Lord, we thank you because the righteousness and mercy has embraced each other, because righteousness and peace came to be in Jesus, your only beloved Son. Thank you because of your mercy and faithfulness that you have shown to each one of us when Jesus was born. Thank you for the promise of your salvation and mercy, for the promise of your forgiveness. Thank you for the promise of life to come. And Lord, we invite you today to our hearts. We want to come close to you so that we can touch your presence, so that we may experience your mercy and forgiveness. Lord, come to our hearts. Be born in each one of us as we pray together, as we sing together, as we listen to your word of scriptures together. Come, Lord Jesus, and dwell in us. May your righteousness and peace, may your mercy and forgiveness be part of us, of our daily life, of our family life, relations, status, and work. Lord, come and bless us, and may your peace shine upon each one of us. Amen.
Kingdom come, thy will be done
The first lesson. In the book of Genesis, the first book of the Bible, we are told how the universe and everything in it came into being, including the creation of human beings. The first humans, Adam and Eve, are given a perfect world by God, but told that while they can eat anything they want, they must not eat the fruit of a particular tree. The serpent tricks Eve by suggesting that she should eat the fruit and not listen to God, and she does so. When this happens, Adam and Eve are filled with new and difficult knowledge. They realize they are naked and cover themselves up, and they also feel ashamed before God and have lost their perfect relationship with Him. The first lesson and prayer will be read by Ms. Chloe Hannah B. Carillo, External Vice President of the Mapúa Central Student Council.
God tells sinful Adam that he has lost the life of paradise, and that his seed will bruise the serpent's head. A reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 8 to 19. They heard the sound of the Lord walking into the garden, in the cool of the day. The man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Then the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." And he said, "Who told you you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave from the tree and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" And the woman said, "The serpent deceived me and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you more than all cattle and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you will go, and dust you will eat all days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise you on the head, and you shall bruise him on the heel." To the woman he said, "I will greatly multiply your pain in childbirth. In pain you will bring forth children. Yet your desire will be for your husband, and he will rule over you." Then to Adam he said, "Because you have listened to the voice of your wife, and have eaten from the tree about which I commanded you, saying you shall not eat from it, cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you will eat from it all days of your life. Both thorns and thistles it shall grow from you, and you will eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you will eat bread, till you return to the ground, because from it you were taken, for you are dust, and to dust you shall return." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord of mercy, despite our sinfulness, you have never stopped loving us. You search for us in our waywardness. Our disobedience had hurt you. Our disobedience disregarded your great free love. For our pride and ungratefulness, your mercy abounds. With bended knees, we humble ourselves to be worthy of your mercy. Amen.
Joyful and trial.
The second lesson. In this reading, we hear about the Hebrew patriarch Abraham. The background of this reading is a test God put before Abraham, asking him to sacrifice his son Isaac. Isaac was the most precious thing in the world to Abraham, but he did not want to disobey what God asked of him. Because Abraham was obedient and did not put his own wants first, God spared Isaac and told Abraham that he would be blessed and become the founder of a great nation. So being willing to lose everything, Abraham gained a wonderful future for his people. The second lesson in prayer will be read by Ms. Erica Bobis, President of the Mapúa Council of Organizations.
A reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 22, verses 11 to 18. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, "Abraham, Abraham." And he said, "Here I am." He said, "Do not stretch out your hand against the lad, and do nothing to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have then withheld your son, your only son, from me." Then Abraham raised his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in the thicket by his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering in the place of his son. Abraham called the name of that place, "The Lord will provide," as it is said to this day, "In the mount of the Lord it will be provided." Then the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, declares the Lord, because you have done this thing and have not withheld your son, your only son, indeed I will greatly bless you, and I will greatly multiply your seed as the stars of the heavens and as the sand which is on the seashore. And your seed shall possess the gate of their enemies. In your seed, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice." Genesis chapter 22, verses 11 to 18. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, you promised that your reign will bring the justice that would never end. Like our forefather Abraham, may we remain faithful to our promise as your chosen people. May our lives serve as our testimony to the covenant that you have made with us. As you have justified Abraham, our ancestor, may we be just to everyone to deserve being justified. Amen.
Night, holy night, oh.
The third lesson. In this reading, the prophet Isaiah tells of a wonderful Savior sent by God to bring a suffering people from darkness to light. Isaiah sees it as a child being born, a son who will bring peace and justice to the world. The third lesson in prayer will be read by Angela Marie Leal, chairperson of the Mapúa Council of Presidents.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. Those who live in a dark land, the light will shine on them. You shall multiply the nation. You shall increase their gladness. They will be glad in your presence, as with the gladness of harvest, as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For you shall break the yoke of their burden and the staff on their shoulders, and the rod of their oppressors, as at the battle of Midian. For every boot of the booted warrior in the battle tumult, and cloak rolled in blood will be for burning, fuel for the fire. For a child will be born to us, a son will be given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders. And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. There will be no end to the increase of his government or of peace. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and righteousness, from then on and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will accomplish this. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, we wait for the day of your peace. May we help to bring this peace in our families, our communities, and our world. Amen.
Sing glory to the newborn time behold it come, offspring of the Virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh the God is he, veiled incarnate is he. Gracious man with man to dwell, Jesus Lord Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
The fourth lesson. The peace that Christ will bring is foreshown. As in the previous reading, the prophet imagines a person emerging from the people of Israel who will transform the community. That person will be close to God and bring justice and equality for the people of God. So, there will be no more war and destruction. The prophet gives us a picture of what that will be like by imagining predator animals and prey existing together without harming each other. Nothing will cause damage or hurt anyone because the world will be as God intended it. The fourth lesson and prayer will be read by Namita Rashinkar, External Vice President of the ARIDBE Student Council.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 11, verses 1 through 9. Then a shoot will spring from the stem of Jesse, and a branch from his roots will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and strength, the Spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord, and he will not judge by what his eyes see, nor make a decision by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he will judge the poor and decide with fairness for the afflicted of the earth. And he will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. Also righteousness will be the belt about his loins, and faithfulness the belt about his waist. And the wolf will dwell with the lamb, and the leopard will lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and the little boy will lead them. Also the cow and the bear will graze, their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The nursing child will play by the hole of the cobra, and the weaned child will put his hand on the viper's den. They will not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain. For the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. God, you are always with us. May we always trust in your presence and share it with those around us. Amen.
Sin, it's
the fifth lesson. Having prepared us to hear about Jesus' birth, the passages now move into one about how the Virgin Mary was chosen to be Jesus' mother. We are told that an angel, God's messenger, came to Mary, a young woman engaged to a man called Joseph, and told her that she had found special favor with God. Because of this, God asked her to conceive a child, a son, Jesus, who has a unique destiny as the Son of God. The fifth lesson and prayer will be read by Sian Zygrid D. Raton, Internal Vice President of CBMES Student Council.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 to 38. Now is the sixth month the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city in Galilee called Nazareth. A virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the descendants of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. Coming in, he said to her, "Greetings, favored one, may the Lord be with you." But she was very perplexed of this statement and kept pondering what kind of salutation this was. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. And for that reason, the Holy Child shall be called the Son of God. And behold, even your relative Elizabeth has also conceived a son in her old age. And she, who was called barren, is now in her sixth month. For nothing will be impossible with God." And Mary said, "Behold, the bondslave of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, you asked Joseph and Mary to trust in you. May we come to share in your trust and always rely on you. Amen.
Stars are brightly shining.
The sixth lesson. Saint Luke tells of the birth of Jesus. This tells us about the actual birth of Jesus. Saint Luke sets the birth in the middle of a census, explaining how Jesus, whose family came from Nazareth, ended up being born in Bethlehem. Joseph takes his pregnant wife Mary to Bethlehem to comply with the Roman Emperor's ruling, and during this process, Mary goes into labor and gives birth to Jesus. The sixth lesson and prayer will be read by Sue Naomi Dalisay, second year representative of EECE Student Council.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke chapter 2 verses 1 to 7. And it came to pass in those days a decree went out from Caesar Augustus to register all the world. This registration first took place when Quirinius was governing Syria, and all were to be registered, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because of his being of the house and family of David, to register with Mary, the one being betrothed to him, she is being with child. And it came to pass in their being there, the days of her giving birth were fulfilled, and she brought forth her firstborn son, and she wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in the manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. The word of the Lord, thanks be to God. Let's pray. Lord, you came to us in humility and vulnerability. May we always show loving care to those around us, especially those in most need. Amen.
Continue day and night, Lord.
the seventh lesson. In another part of the same story, the messenger angel of God visits some shepherds out in the hillside and tells them that Jesus has been born. They are not special, but ordinary people. But the message to them is to be happy because Jesus has come to be a savior for people like them. The seventh lesson and prayer will be read by Francie Danielle Martin, President of ETY-SBM Student Council.
A reading from the Gospel of St. Luke chapter 2 verses 8 to 16. In the same region, there were some shepherds staying out in the fields and keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord suddenly stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terribly frightened. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be for all the people. For today in this city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find the baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there appeared with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men, with whom he is pleased." When the angels had gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds began saying to one another, "Let us go straight to Bethlehem then, and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." So they came in a hurry and found their way to Mary and Joseph and the baby as he lay in the manger. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Lord, you are the giver of all good gifts. May we always remember to share our gifts with others for the glory of your name. Amen.
The eighth lesson, the wise men are led by the star to Jesus. This passage from a different gospel, St. Matthew, tells us about a different group of people who heard the good news about Jesus' birth. In this case, some wise men who were probably foreign star watchers looking for signs in the night sky came to King Herod, the local governor, asking about a new king of the Jews that they had heard about. They were following a star in the night sky, which they understood to be a sign. The eighth lesson and prayer will be read by Ashira Angela L. Cabuco, Amusement and Recreation Committee member of SCEGE Student Council.
A reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Gathering together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this is what has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the leaders of Judah. For out of you shall come forth a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called the Magi and determined from them the exact time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search carefully for the child. And when you have found him, report to me, so that I too may come and worship him.' After hearing the king, they went their way, and the star which they had seen in the east went on before them, until it came and stood over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. After coming into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they fell to the ground and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they presented to him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned by God in a dream not to return to Herod, the Magi left for their own country by another way." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. God of power and might, you are beyond all time and space. A manger for king is a clear manifestation of your humility. May we never fail to recognize your majesty and give praise to you in all we do. Amen.
Singing o'er the
The ninth lesson, Simeon in the temple. Awaiting the consolation of Israel, Simeon, speaking about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Jerusalem, represents the hopes and expectations of faithful and devout Jews. The birth of Jesus brings hope to fulfillment. The ninth lesson and prayer will be read by John Michael M. Bea, President of SSSE Student Council.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him. And apart from Him, nothing more came into being that has come into being. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There came a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify about the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but he came to testify about the light. He was a true light which coming into the world enlightens every man. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and those who were his own did not receive him, but as many received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God. Even to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of the man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we saw his glory, glory as of the only begotten from the Father, full of grace and truth. The Word of the Lord, thanks be to God. Lord, you call us to be your witnesses to the ends of the earth, that our thoughts and ideas remark with wisdom of the godly, fill our words with power, that we may proclaim our good news and draw all people to you. Let our actions manifest your ways in charity, goodness, and mercy, so that in our earthly journey, our life is well lived in your grace. Amen.
To the world, the Lord.
In the spirit of Christmas, let us all join the community prayer to be led by Alfred Samuel Nunez, internal vice president of the Mapúa Senior High School Student Council, and to be followed by the benediction.
The day of joy returns, Father in heaven, and crowns another year with peace and goodwill. Help us rightly to remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in the song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and the worship of the wise men. Close the doors of hate, and open the doors of love all over the world, and let kindness come with every gift, and good desires with every greeting. Deliver us from evil by the blessing that Christ brings, and teach us to be merry with clean hearts. May the Christmas season make us happy as a whole Mapuan community with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven, for Jesus' sake. Amen.
Let us listen to the closing message of Mr. Oliver Ryan B. Custodio, MCS Advisor.
Christmas season brings us a certain feeling of excitement and joy, maybe because of the dazzling lights around us, the decors, the food, the parties, the music, the gifts we receive. Things which brings a festive mood. But behind all those lights, behind all those gifts, this activity of the Mapúa Cardinal Singers invites us to look deeper on the real meaning of the season. That is, the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The birth of Christ is a gift to all of us, God's gift to mankind. This gift gives us a certain feeling of hope, gives us a certain feeling of love, a love that is eternal, a love that is beyond any material consideration. So as we reflect deeper on the meaning of this season, let us look at God's love for us. Let us remember our family, our friends. Let us all be an instrument in bringing out the message of hope and inspiration to everyone. May we all be a symbol of God's love, in bringing out the message of positivity, in sharing kindness, in making productive use of our talents and skills, in sharing our resources, in serving our communities, in serving our nation, in discerning for our next leaders. Huwag po natin kakalimutan na dito sa Mapúa, isang komunidad po tayo na pinagbubuklod ng pag-ibig at pag-asa. Maligayang Pasko po sa ating lahat at naway patuloy tayong gabayan ng ating Panginoong may kapal. Salamat po.
Let us all sing, Ang Pasko ay Sumapit.
Ang magagandang hirap dahil sa ang Diyos ay pag-ibig. Na si Kristo'y isila, may tatlong haring at sidalaw, at ang bawat isa ay nagsipaghandog ng tanging alay. Bagong taon ay magbagong buhay, nang lumikaya ang ating bayan. Tayo'y magsikap upang makamtan natin ang kasaganahan. Tayo'y magsiawit habang ang mundo'y tahimik. Ang araw ay sumapit ng sanggol na dulot ng langit. Tayo ay magmahalan at sundin ang gintong aral, at magbuhat kayo kahit hindi Pasko ay magbigayan. Bagong taon ay magbagong buhay, nang lumigaya ang ating bayan. Tayo'y magsikap upang makamtan natin ang kasaganahan. Tayo'y magsiawit habang ang mundo'y tahimik. Ang araw ay sumapit ng sanggol na dulot ng langit. Tayo ay magmahalan at sundin ang gintong aral, at magbuhat kayo kahit hindi Pasko ay magbigayan.
Thank you for joining us today in our service. See you again next year in our second Mapuan Lessons and Carols. Have a wonderful Christmas and a new year to all. May God bless you.